and as such requires that we take real firm and clear decisions that will be in the interests of the party.
President of Nigeria, Muhammadu Buhari. Meantime, a caretaker committee has been announced and it will be headed by the governor of Yobe State, Mayor Mada Gumi. And that's it. Thank you for watching. I am BC Adewale.
Good afternoon, my ever conscious Edo people. Sorry, 1 minute, please. Yes, 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 yes. Good afternoon, my ever-conscious Edo people. My ever-conscious Edo people, I remain yours, noble right activist, comrade I, Bogu Emmanuel. I want to say good afternoon to all of you again because there's a fair good news on the air. I'm not too happy, but God knows best. The number one leader of the APC has just ruled. In fact, in his deposition, he actually said that the NEC stands dissolved and the current National Working Committee stands dissolved. And all pending litigations, you know, in the APC, particularly that even contesting Oshomole suspension and the rest, stands dissolved. In fact, should be put all aside. And I want to say a big thank you to Adams Ali Oshomole. I am one man who has, in many forums and many platforms, criticized the person of Adams Ali Oshomole because I have certain reservations. But as of today, because of the statesmanship, the cautious position of Oshomole's political, recent Oshomole's political antecedents, you know, in seeing that the political abnormalities that he created in Edo State, you know, was resolved, even if that led to the exit of his person as the national chairman. I commend him for that fight. He has further shown to Edo people that he has their interests at heart. And for many who, you know, reading between the lines, I am a human rights activist. In the last 1 month, I have decided to support the emergence of Pastor Saige Zeyamu under the APC platform. The support we got, however, saw to him emerging as the APC candidate. As of today, Buhari has not cancelled that primaries. He has only called for a ratification. I believe today Pastor still remains the candidate of the APC. And for me, I believe that the APC itself will not have a time to reshape and, if possible, call for a Congress. But one thing here is paramount, that Oshomole has been able to right the wrongs. However, because of the political atmosphere, I would not want to say certain statements, because some of us are politically inclined with, you know, the day-to-day happenings of the APC. But I want to say one thing today, that furthermore, the APC as a party has further shown that the minority can actually have, you know, a way over the majority. And I give kudos to them for that. But I also give Oshomole more kudos for actually setting the pace that the majority must always have their way. The political antecedent that must have played out in the past few weeks of litigation, counter-litigation, and thereabout, I must say this today to my people, that it has shown that our democracy is still growing. But only very few persons can absorb what I'm saying because of their level of understanding. But very many would begin to read across board, trying to whip sentiments and all sort of illicit argument. But as far as some of us are concerned, because we are stakeholders in the process, even as non-state actors, we are stakeholders because our voices are not just being heard, but they are notable voices. We believe that Pastor Saigeze Yamu has the capacity not only to win elections, but to manage governance. We believe that the best of Obaseki is what we have seen in the last 3 years, which is that today, when this historic push that will calm the nerves of political antecedents in Edo State, particularly within the APC, I strongly believe that Pastor Saigeze Yamu will not only win the ballot, but will put his name, you know, on the developmental landmark achievement leaders that we would have in Edo State. You know, his passion for leadership, his zeal for bringing people together, for appealing to persons to, you know, to believe in a cause, you know, has brought him this far. I tell you, Pastor Saigeze Yamu did not only merit this opportunity being given to him as the governorship candidate of the APC, but he also merited being the governor of Edo State for the last 4 years. And that has shown us that whether you like it or not, even if Obaseki has been given the platform to, you know, preside over the governance of Edo State within the last 3.5 years, we have seen the best of what he can do. So why I'm taking pains to explain all of this is that if you take a deeper look into the issues of governance, particularly with the business of the present administration claiming that they don't want to share Edo money, they don't want to share Edo money. If you take a closer look at what have happened within, you know, the last 1 month, it clearly shows that taxpayers' monies accrued to the state have been hijacked by not only the governor, but also political associates that, you know, romances with him today, even at the PDP. You saw when Governor Yusuf Wike came to address the National Working Committee of the PDP to be tax collectors. And we all know what that means in our ordinary society. It is no longer news that, as of today, the emergence of Pastor Eze Yamu as our candidate in the APC, you will see it as a politically driven process, you know, from buying of forms to nomination of candidates to party primaries to, you know, his emergence as the winner, you will see that it is driven from people-oriented participation, not money-purchasing ventures that we have witnessed on the other side. And these are part of the issues that our governor has said, you know, in time past that he wants to right the wrongs over. Over 10 billion naira speculated, you know, on the media to have been spent on getting the APC, the PDP ticket. As I speak to you, the ticket has not even been confirmed, you know, but at every instances, the supporters of Obaseki celebrates the dwindling crisis in the APC as if it's the victory of an election. But just as some of us have rightly said, because we understand the political terrain we find ourselves, we know that Pastor will be governor come November 12th. He will be sworn into Asadebe Avenue because I know for sure that he will win my ward. He will win other wards that I know, you know, are on the majority side of the 192 wards we have in Edo State. Cutting across Edo North, Edo Central, Edo South, as the case may be. So for some of us who have this knowledge of political and activism in our environment, we are urging Edo people to now leave their minds out of the politics, because whether you like it or not today, as at 2 days ago or a night ago, they said Ubede Yama has withdrew the court case from a court Port Harcourt and Federal High Court. They also came out to say that Riceman a few hours ago also cashed out and decided to withdraw his support for the ticket of the governorship election for him aspiring as the Edo 2020 gubernatorial candidate for the PDP. He has also stepped down for Obaseki. So what you are seeing today is an already presided primaries going on. But however, they have conducted their primaries and it's still being conducted, and a winner will emerge. But why I say we should leave our minds away from those political activities, because I know the two major candidates that will be in the ballot, it's Obaseki and Ezeyamu. Now, why we are going to be having Obaseki and Ezeyamu, I want us to talk on the basis of achievements and, you know, value of resources made available to government. Because we have seen in less than a week, 10 billion naira, a whooping sum of 10 billion, you know, being expended. We have even seen where co-governors, you know, in the same political platform with our governors are today, are accusing our governor of patronizing tax collectors as National Working Committee. And we know when tax collectors are now National Working Committee members, they don't collect documents, they only collect cash, as the case may be. So for me, it's a success, because whether you like it or not, in a war, there must be a winner and there must be a loser. And while the winner wins, the winner must also count his losses. And while the loser loses, he must also count his own losses. So these are what is expected in any political battle that we have just witnessed. But one thing is sure is that the interest on both sides of the divide still stands. As of today, there are three contending persons who have purchased the APC ticket that are still within the APC. In the person of Odubu, Osare Obaze, Matthew Duekeme, there are about four persons, and Pastor Osagyeze Iyamu. And as far as I know, the APC structures in Edo State, I see Anese Iyamu emerging as the sole candidate of the APC. So, as of today, I want everybody to ensure that they rid their minds of this sentiment of Oshomole, Oshomole. I'm so happy that while we are approaching the polls, even if that is a loss on the part of Edo people, particularly the APC, I'm so happy that the two factors do not have any national representative from the state within their political party. So the influences they will pull will be on the ballots with the electorates. So I stand to say today that 70% of those persons who win elections in the PDP, have joined pastor to the APC. As of today, in fact, in my world, I stand to tell you that PDP ceases to exist. In the last election, if you all remember, I supported Matthew Roide, I supported Issa Edenye, you know, and they all emerged. Those same structures that did that work are with pastor today. Very many persons in the PDP, I bet you within now and September 19th, will leave the PDP to the APC. But you will see lesser numbers of persons in the APC moving over to the even as of today, councillors that the governor boasted were going to leave with him are not leaving. Local government chairman that both some of them have all resigned, you know, from following the governor in his white goose chase, you know, to the PDP. But however, Edo people would have to decide because power, they say, belongs to the people, and we are in a democratic setting, so we have to go to the ballots. But however, while we are going to the ballot, I tell you that my candidate, Pastor Sagezi Yamu, stands a 101% chance of clinching the tickets. So, for those of us who are my followers, who listen to me, who have been waiting for me for the news, if you observe very well, some of us don't come out to give you false news. You know, although even this afternoon we said the neck meeting has been called off, we could not come up with it because it was not substantial. We felt that when they went into that meeting, having a discussion, they will call up the meeting. But I only came out to hear that the National Working Committee has been dissolved. So I think, including that of Gedam, to everybody has been dissolved. So I think in the fourth week or thereabout, APC should be looking for towards the coming, calling for another sub-convention. But I think that should be after the Edo elections to appoint or elect national leaders, as the case may be. But what is paramount today is that Edo people now have a candidate that they believe in a political party that wins elections also. So let us go into the ballots. Let us also be strong, because the battle ahead is not an easy one, but it will be fought and won. You know, so however, I just want persons to know that the Edo polity is in a balance fix. Whether you like it or not, you still had the pastor Ize Yamu who contested in the PDP against Obaseki in 2016, and him again contesting against an Obaseki in the PDP in 2020. So it is a give and take situation, but however, all factors, particularly Adamso Somole, all factors that saw to the emergence of Pastor Sagezi Yamu as the flag bearer of the APC, I want to commend each and every one of you for a job well done. I want to also lend my voice to our comrade governor, ex-governor Adamsali Osomole, national chairman of the APC as of today, because whether you like it or not, a convention has not been held, so he still deserves some respect in that title of office. Despite the fact that they have been suspended by the leader of the party, he still deserves some title. As far as I'm concerned, Adamsali Osomole has proven to we, the Edo people, that he can actually correct his mistakes. He can actually correct those abnormalities that he did initially. And for me, ratifying it in the sense of what he ought to be, I believe it was the best form of decision that he took as a political element, as a political gladiator, and as a stakeholder in the Edo political space. So however, as the case may be, I want to beg each and every Edo person, whether you are supporting the governor, because I have very many friends who are also supporting the governor. I have very many friends who are also supporting a pastor. So let us not see violence as a resolve, because with the way the policy is going now, we now have a balanced arena for everybody to go and show their popularity. So let us not test that popularity on the grounds of violence. These are some of the issues as a, you know, an open-minded person we shall use to orientate and enlighten our people, because as of today, whether you like it or not, it is the APC and the PDP that will meet in the elections. So these are the issues. These are the issues. However, I want to use the opportunity to say thank you to all of you, particularly those persons who have been calling and calling. In fact, last night was terrible. I had calls till about 3 a.m. in the morning, and you know, it's all well, but we pray that God gives us the strength to continue the task ahead and come out victorious, because we have already done the needed assessment, and I believe winning the elections is no problem, because I know people believe so much in pastor and they have not seen anything different, you know, that has happened in Edo State, despite the fact that renovations upon renovation, you know, has been the order of the day. The over 150,000 jobs that the governor said has created, which is not visible, we are still finding touch to balance that statistics of the governor. And for me, in such a situation, it's a win-win thing, because in our today era, we have seen where people who do not live by, you know, their campaign promises have been shown the way out. And I think Edo political space will not be, you know, a different thing entirely. So this is where I want to draw the curtain close. But before I leave, I want to commend Adam Saliu Oshomole again. I want to say thank you, Baba. In fact, you have shown that you are a true leader. You have shown that you know the cry of Edo people. We the common Edo people, you have shown that you know our cry. Because in 2017, 2016, when we cried this cry, you were, you know, not listening. But now, in 2020, when you have tested and seen that the cry we were crying were very legitimate, you came out quickly to make amends and saw that you played your own role, you know, in your own capacity, to see how you, what you can do to better, you know, that situation. So for some of us who know the pains it has taken, we want to say thank you. We want to say God will continue to elevate you. We want to say that God will never neglect you the way you never neglected Edo people. We want to also say that better days are ahead. Better days are ahead. You came, you saw, and you are still conquering. So for me, I believe you have done well. And I also want to say that in no distant time, your name shall be written in the book of life for those who contributed immensely, you know, having seen the situation on ground to the development in our state. Because as far as I'm concerned, your developmental landmarks has not been surpassed. So we want to see an Eze Yamu, a pastor with address that can actually meet up to that space bar or yastic bar you have actually created in the developmental landmark of Edo State, and do what is expected of a governor that wants to work for Edo people. So we want to say at this junction that we commend you. We say God bless you. God continue to strengthen you, give you all the support and grace you need to continue in your good works. I say thank you. I have so much respect for you. And we know God will continue to elevate you, as the case may be. Before I leave also, this afternoon, I want to commend all the EPM members. All the EPM members, particularly those ones who stood their grounds despite the hard times, despite the shaky, stormy, and the tedious politicking all through, from the declaration of INEC calendar for the Edo elections, before that time till date, those of you who have also stand on the path of truth to speak truth, despite the fact that you have been called all sort of names by ill-informed persons, I want to say thank you for making yourself available to see that this dream that we have all waited for have always come true. So once again, do not expect anything less from some of us, because we are believing and focusing on ensuring that the Edo project is put first before any other group of individuals, whether in power or out of power. Edo, the interest of Edo must be first, must be paramount, must be sacrosanct, to see how we drive the state forward, because we are persons who will partake in the lifespan of years, as God may permit us with the life. But very many of these persons who are causing damages today cannot attain that milestone as far as man and humanity is concerned. So having said all of this, I want to check how many shares we have on this weighty broadcast, and ask that you give us a share. If you are watching, I know most of my supporters are at work, but if you are watching and you are a listener of truth, and you believe so much in the development of Edo State, I want you to quickly place your hands on the share button. You know, we are not all those loud-mouthed social media bloggers or activists who come on the media just to make noise. We give you accurate information. As far as I'm concerned, when we came on board to declare our support for Pastor, we said we were going to make sure that those social media space is not occupied by false information. And as far as I'm concerned, I know you all that are watching, that are reasonable, knows that I, Emmanuel Bogun, has ensured that real-time information, information that are verifiable, information that are backed with facts, information that are not propagandist in nature, is the order of the day, is the order of my reports, is the order of my discourse. So having said all of this, I want to thank every one of you who have stood by the emergence of Pastor. I want to say that on behalf of Pastor, he will not let you down. And also say that some of us will also continue to do the needful. Just as we expose the ills in the Obaseki government, we shall not fail in our role as social crusaders to ensure that we tongue lash, expose, and criticize our candidate we are supporting when it comes to the general issue of governance. If he emerges, you know, the winner of the September 19th general elections to be held in Edo State. So having adumbrated this far, I want to say thank you. I want to say continue to live in faith that God, just as he protected his children from the land of Egypt, will also drive us, we the Edo people, we the majority Edo people, out of the hands of this faith from the governor that we have as of today. So once again, I say a big thank you to you. Continue to remain with us. Continue to listen to the good message we have. Once again, I say God bless you all. Remember, violence is not a cause in this our quest. God going to bless Edo State. God going to bless the Federal Republic of Nigeria. Oba Atokpe, he said. So once again, I say thank you. Join me live in the evenings, because my phone lines will be thrown open so that we can actually discuss our issues and the way forward. Thank you and God bless you. Please, if you have not shared this broadcast, endeavor to place your hands on the share button. If you are of the POI support group, please share this broadcast. If you are that of the Obaseki Togba group, share this broadcast, because we are preaching peace. Let us not toe the path of violence. The blood of any Edo person is not worth this election. So let us not reason that on that platform. So if you are just joining us and you have not shared this broadcast, try to share it before you watch, because I'm about leaving, and try to listen to the weighty information some of us have put out there. Remember, sharing this broadcast is supporting our work. Once again, thank you and God bless you. Join me 10 p.m. this night as we throw our lines open. So if you are a POI member, if you are a member of Progressive Minds in Edo, please let me show you exhibit some love before I leave.